पैकेज सपोर्ट्स एप्लेट्स. सपोर्ट फॉर बोथ इनपुट आउटपुट एंड एप्लेट्स कम फ्रॉम जावा कोर एपीआई लाइब्रेरीज, नॉट फ्रॉम लैंग्वेज कीवर्ड्स. फॉर दिस रीजन एंड इन डेप्थ डिस्कशन ऑफ दीज टॉपिक्स वी विल टॉपिक्स इज फाउंड इन द कमिंग वीडियोज विच एग्जामिन्स द जावा एपीआई क्लासेस. So in this video we discuss about the foundation of these two subsystems so that you can see how they are integrated into the Java language and how they fit into the larger context of Java programming and last of Java keywords: transient, volatile, instance of, native, strict FP and assert. So it concludes the discussing static import, describing another use for this keyword and introducing the compact profile, a feature added by JDK 8. As you may have noticed while reading the preceding previous videos, not much use has been input output in the example programs. In fact, aside from print and println, none of the IO methods have been used significantly. So the reason is simple: most real applications of Java are not text based console program, rather they are either graphically oriented program that rely on one Java graphical user interface framework such as Swing, AWT, JavaFX for user interaction, or they are web applications although text-based. Console programs are excellent as teaching examples. They do not constitute an important use for Java in the real world. Also, Java support for console input-output is limited and somewhat awkward to use even in simple example program. So text-based console input output is just not that useful in real world Java programming. So the preceding topics, notwithstanding, Java does provide strong flexible support of input output as it relates to files and networks. Java input output system is cohesive and consistent. In fact, once you understand its fundamental, the rest of the input output system is easy to master. So a general overview of input output is presented here. For detailed description, we will make another video for it. Streams. Java program perform input output through streams. A stream is an abstraction that either produces or consumes information. Stream is a link to a physical device by the Java input output system. All streams behave in the same manner even if the actual physical devices to which they are linked differ. Thus, the same input output classes and methods can be applied to different type of devices. So this means that an input stream can abstract many different kinds of input from a disk file and a keyboard or network socket. Likewise, an input and output stream may refer to the console disk file and disk file and network connection. Streams are a clean way to deal with input output without having every part of your code understand the difference between a keyboard and a network. For example, Java implements streams within class hierarchies defined in the Java IO package. So in addition to the stream input output defined, the Java input IO, Java also provides buffer and channel based IO, which is defined in Java and IO in its sub package, and we will discuss briefly in coming videos. So let's come to the topic here: byte streams and character streams. Java defined two types of stream: byte stream and character stream. Byte streams provide a convenient means for handling input and output of bytes. Byte streams are used, for example, when reading or writing binary data, and character stream provide a convenient means of handling input-output character. They use Unicode and therefore can be internalized input-output of characters. They use Unicode therefore, okay. So also in some cases, character stream are more efficient than byte stream. So nowadays, character stream mostly used. So character stream are defined by using two class hierarchies. At the top are abstract class reader and writer. These abstract classes handle Unicode character stream. Java has several concrete subclasses of each of these. So let's come to byte stream. Byte stream are defined by using two class hierarchies. At the top are two abstract classes, input and output stream. Each of these abstract classes has several concrete subclasses that handle the differences among various devices such as disk file, network connection and even memory buffer. So the byte stream classes in Java IO are shown in these programs which we will discuss in this video. So So remember, to use the stream classes, you must import Java IO. So for using the use of these classes, we have to import java.io. So the stream classes are buffered input stream, output stream, array input stream, byte array output stream, data input stream, and all. And for character stream, buffer reader, buffer writer, char array. Okay, so let's come to the topic. Our main purpose is to see the programs. So here is the program, and this is the use a buffer reader to read characters from the console. So here is a package, and we are imported here java.io. Class name is br read, and public static you already know about it, and this is a throws IO exception. Here is the data type is char, and buffered reader and new buffer reader, then input stream, reader system in, then system out, println and enter character, q to quit. And for reading characters, we are using here while loop. Okay, so this output may look a little different from what you expected, because system.in is line buffered by default. So this means that no input is actually passed to the program until you press enter. As you can guess, this does not make read particularly valuable for interactive console input. So let's run this program and see the output. So in this example program, such as those shown is in this program, but in more sophisticated application, you can handle the exception explicitly. So this is a program. So here is enter character q to quit. So we have to write something. So I am typing 1, 2 and 3. So I am typing numeric values, and for quitting we have to type q. Okay, so they are showing you this. So here we pressed enter. Okay, so let's go to another program, br read lines java. So read string from console using buffer reader. So here is we imported java.io package IO, then this is the program name, class name, and this is for public static void main. Program starts from here and throws IO exception. Then this command, this line is the same. Then string str, because we are using a string, and this is for printing, and this is a while loop, string read line and print. So while not str dot equals to stop. So let's run this and see the output. So here is enter line of text and enter stop to quit. जब हमें quit करना होगा, then we have to press stop for quitting. Then stop. Program success. So let's go to another program. So this example, it creates a tiny text editor. It creates an array of string objects and then reads in lines of text, storing each line in the array. It will read up to 100 line until you enter stop. So it uses buffer reader to read from console. So this is the program here. So here, so we don't need to import all packages. Import java.io is enough here. So this is a class name, and this is the starting of main program. Then these lines are same string str new string, and is 100 because 100 lines are there. So enter the line of text, and these are print statement, and we are using here for loop, and I is less than 100, and this is an incrementing I, and S string I, read line, and this. So let's go to another program. So the another program is here is writing console output. So console output is most easily accomplished with println. Described earlier, which are used in most of the examples. So these methods are defined by the print stream, which is type of object preferred referenced by stream.out. Even though system.out is a byte stream, using it for simple program output is still acceptable. However, character-based alternative is described in the next section. So because print stream is an output string derived from output stream, it also implements the low-level method write. So thus, write can be used to write to the console. The simplest form of write defined by print stream is shown here. So void write in byte. Well, this method writes the type byte specified by byte value. So although byte is described as an integer, only the low order 8 bits are written. Here is a short example that uses write to output the character A followed by new line to the script. So demonstrate here is system.out, right? So you can see here. So if we run this program, so what will happen? Because there is a data type is int, b is variable, and a. And we are printing a b. So let's see. So it is showing here b, because we are printing a b. So let's go to the another program, and this is PrintWriter class. So PrintWriter supports the print and println methods. Thus you can use these methods in the same way as you used with the system.out. If an argument is not simple type, the PrintWriter method call for objects to string method, then display the result. To write to the console by using PrintWriter, specify system.out for the output stream and automatic flushing. For example, this line of code creates a PrintWriter that is connected to console output. So PrintWriter, and this is the line here. So the following application illustrates using PrintWriter to handle console output. To demonstrate, here's a demonstration of PrintWriter, and import java.io. As usual, we are importing. Then this is the new line here for PrintWriter. Then print pw that println, this is a string, and this int is a data type, I is variable, and we are initializing with -7. Then here is print ln and I and double D. Then this is, so pw to print ln and D. So here you can see reading or writing.